Hey Libras, Yana speaks here, and in this video, I am doing your love reading for the month of November, and this is your mid-November 2020 love reading. Now, I do want to start off by saying that all of my readings are general, so they may or may not resonate with you because not every single Libra is going through the same exact thing. So if you find that this reading does not resonate, then it would be in your best interest to book a private reading with me. All the information to do so will be in the description below. All right? So let's get started. What is the overall energy for Libras this month? Okay, we have Three of Cups. Okay, so there's some type of celebration amongst you and your friends. You know, this could also be some type of third party situation. I'm going to see as I go deeper into the reading. We do have the Four of Pentacles here, the High Priestess. This is mirroring the Virgo reading. So some of you could be dealing with a Virgo. Okay. Ooh, sorry. So. Okay. I feel like there is a third party interference. And I'm seeing two things here. So it could be that the person you're involved with has a third party and you feel very ignored because they have this other person. This third party could be their friends. Maybe this person puts the friends before you. Maybe they put their family before you. Maybe this person likes to go out a lot and drink and stuff like that, and you feel neglected, you feel ignored. For others of you, this is what you're doing, okay? I'm gonna be honest though, I do feel like you guys are in a connection where the person puts a third party before you, whether this be family, cheating, or friends. Honestly, I really don't see cheating. I really feel like this is friends. You know, I feel like you're dating someone who is immature. But although you feel ignored and rejected by this person, you're still holding on to them because you do feel like this person is your soulmate. And you do feel like you guys have a very spiritual connection. And, you know, you're almost kind of like going into your bag of tricks. You know, you're trying to think of like what you can do to make this person put in more effort, what you can do to become more interesting, you know, to them, what you can do to make them want to spend more time with you and not these third party interferences. So you're really like trying to, you know, think, really trying to use your intuition, like what your intuition tells you. Because like I said, you do want to be with this person. You feel like this person is worth being with. We do have the Two of Pentacles here. That's why I feel like there's some type of love triangle or third party interference going on. I don't mean to say love triangle because I really don't feel like it's cheating. I meant to say I feel like there is third party interference. I really feel it's friendship. I really feel like your person really struggles with balancing you and their friends, you know. And I feel like your feelings are very up and down about it, you know. Some days you're okay, some days you're really sad. You know, your feelings are all over the place, okay? There's the King of Pentacles here. So this person is, you know, self-centered. They're a bit, you know, into themselves, more into their stability, more into their career. You know, they struggle with really being committed to relationships in a sense of giving their all to their partner. But with the Nine of Cups, this is a wish fulfillment for you. This is someone that you've always wished for. This is someone you've always wanted. So maybe this is someone you know for a long time, you always wanted them. Or this could be like, you know, maybe as a kid you envisioned what you wanted in someone, and this person fulfills all of those things. So you want it to work, okay? So I'm gonna ask Spirit, how does this person feel about the Libras? The Ace of Pentacles, the Ace of Swords, the Knight of Wands, of course, the Hangman, Seven of Cups, the Eight of Cups. I mean, I feel your person is very confused. I feel like your person wants a new start with you, wants things to be more stable with you. but then at the same time, they don't. It's like they're very, it's like they want a new start with you. They want to make things more stable between you two, right? But I'm hearing in my head, not right now. It's almost like this person saying, like, let me get to the bag. Let me do what I want to do. You know. And I really feel like this person is going to kind of tell you that too. You know, a part of their inconsistency, like a part of them being like hot and cold with you and sending you mixed signals and not really investing in you, is because they have not really emotionally like connected to this like situation. You know, this person, I feel, could be like, you could be dealing with someone who doesn't like to sit still, that likes to be all over the place. That's why they always with their friends. This is someone who's always on the go. They could do a job where they're constantly on the go, like they travel a lot. But I feel like they have not allowed themselves to emotionally connect with you. So this is why it's very easy for them not to give you the attention that you're looking for. I mean, I do feel they care about you. There's something here, but they're not really like 100% invested. They are also keeping their options open too. And I'm gonna be honest with you, you know, I was really trying to say I didn't see that third party, you know, situation with the cheating, because I don't always want to be quick to see that. But when I see that Seven of Cups here, that Two of Pentacles and Three of Cups, yeah. For some of you, this person, you know, is cheating and dealing with other people or keeping their options open. So I'm going to ask Spirit, is this even worth the Libra putting more effort into? No. They go to Seven of Swords. No. I feel like they're cheating with someone from their past. And Spirit's saying that this whole thing is so unstable. Okay, so I'm going to ask Spirit for some advice. Stay optimistic about your love life. You deserve love and deception. Someone is wearing a false mask. And there goes that Seven of Swords right here, which is all about deception. So, Libras, I'm going to end this reading here. I do hope you guys find it helpful. I'm sorry, I'm clearing my throat. Whew. As I'm literally recording this reading, I just turned and it's official.